In this, we'll actually look at creating some our own defined formulas, right? Probably there may be a lot of applications, or there may be a lot of scenarios where Excel formula may not be sufficient. We'll take a simple classic case of let's say I want to find out what is in a few user defined formulas we'll try to create, where I would like to find out find the date corresponding to the third Sunday of August 2012. There is no direct formula that is available in Excel which will actually give me the date given like this. Probably if I give a date, there is a formula which can give me whether it is a Sunday or what is it, but there is nothing which can give me the date when I give this as an input. Or probably I'll do one more. Find the sum of the top 10 scores in a data. In any data, the top 10, just add them. So probably sum of n numbers. Whether it is 10 or 3 or 5, when I say sum of n, it should give me a value for those n numbers. So this is also a direct formula which is not there in Excel. So because I may use it regularly, I may want to design one formula which can address this. Or probably given a first name and last name of a person, or probably first name, middle name and last name, design a code, design a ID code which will contain first three characters of first name, middle or first two characters of middle name, and last three characters of last name. I want to design one identity code for every person. So instead of, I want to write my own formula for that. Right? So probably I will maintain a formula name called ID code. So when I say equal to ID code of something, 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 it should directly give me the code corresponding to that. So these are some of the things where which are more customized to my requirement, and I really don't have anything directly that can be used in Excel. So that's where I am thinking that I will design my own formula so that I can use it as a part of my application. I'll design my own formula so that I can use it wherever required. Right? So let's start off with this thing. So when I say find the date corresponding to third Sunday of August 2012, what are my inputs here? The third could be first, second, third, whatever it is. So the number is one input. Which which weekday. The weekday is another input, Sunday, Monday kind of thing. Then month is another input, year is another input. These four I should give as input, and output wise I should get the date. Right? So this is what I'll define as my function. Now let's see how do we define this into the same. I'll write a new module for this. Right? Instead of using sub, I'll use function. Because when I want to use something as when I want to create my own formula, it's better that I use a function tab, not a sub. Because sub will not return anything, but the function will return an output. So I will like to use function and not the sub. So I will say function, right? Probably date from, or what is the name we'll give? Date finder. We'll give the formula called, we'll call it as date finder, which means in our Excel sheet, if I say equal to date finder later, right now it is not there, but later when I say equal to date finder, it will actually give me some kind of, it takes those four things as input and it should give me as an output. So once we do it, you will get a clarity more better. So I am defining a function called date finder. What are the inputs it is taking? It will take n. N is the nth weekday, third weekday, second week, second Sunday, fourth Monday, something like that. So probably I'll call it as nth itself. Right? Nth is one input which you are giving. What is the type of that input? Nth is an integer. Right? Nth, probably you can define it as a byte also, because it's not a big one. But still, let's give it as an integer. This is like third. So 3 is input. Sunday, one more input. Sunday or Monday. So weekday. Right? So WK day is what I call. WK day is what I call. And I'll call it as integer. You have to give like Sunday equal to 1 to Saturday equal to 7. Right? So we'll say that is one more input I have to give. The third input I have to give is month. Right? So probably MTH is what I am calling, or MNTH I'll call. To be, otherwise NTH and they are getting confused. MNTH. I cannot use the full word as it is. They are all reserved words. Right? So that's where I am using slightly closer. Right? So MTH, MNTH, I am calling it as another integer. Right? And even year. I have to give even the year also as an input. So YR. As another integer. These are the four inputs it has to take. And finally, what is the output it has to give as? It has to give the output as date. This is a mandatory structure for any function. The inputs which will go into the formula. Any formula we put it in brackets something, right? Those are the inputs. Right? Those are the inputs. So those have to be given first of all. So it means whenever I write a formula called equal to date finder, I have to give those four as inputs and it will give me the date as the output. So the whatever the output type, I have to specify it after the bracket as this thing. That's a mandatory structure. Now that is what it will create its own end function and all that stuff. Right? Now, whatever the inputs we have given here, they have to be taken into some variables. I'll take all those four into some variables. So I'll define dim n as integer, right? And similarly, dim WD weekday as integer, dim M as integer month, and dim Y as integer. So whatever the person has entered as inputs, I'll take them like N equal to NTH. These are the inputs which the user has entered. So I am taking them into my formula as a part of the calculations. So I am saying N equal to NTH, WD equal to WK day, correct? Then M equal to MNTH. All these four I am taking into my variables list. And similarly, Y equal to YR. This is one step where I have taken all those values. Now I have to find out how do I find out? I need to first start with the first day of the month. First day of that month, what is the weekday corresponding to that? Right? So I have to frame a date. I have to frame a date from the month, year and the date. Right? So I will even define dim dt as another integer. Then I will say for dt is equal to 1 to 31. There are 31 possible dates. Right? So I'll call it as next. So in the middle, what I'll do is, okay, now I know the month and the year. The date comes from this. Right? And probably I'll even define dim count. How many weeks are elapsed? I need to have some kind of a count. So I'll maintain dim count as an integer. Right? Now let's say, initially I will set count equal to 0. Right? Which means from the first day, there is nothing much that has come out. So the first day is what I will find out, what is the weekday corresponding to that. Right? Dim D as date. I'll take one more D, for which I'll compile it as date based on day, month and year. Right? So I will say D equal to date. No, there is no function called date. D equal to date serial. Date serial is the value where it is taking year as integer, month as integer, day as integer. I'll get the date corresponding to that. So year is Y. This is the year. The month for me is M. And the day is DT. This is the date. Right? This is the date for me. This date, I will find out the weekday corresponding to this date. Right? So current weekday is also current weekday. I'll call it as integer. So for this date, I'll call current weekday is equal to weekday of the date is D and the weekday is starting from Sunday. The week is starting from Sunday. So I'll get the current weekday as this much. If current weekday is equal to the weekday whatever we are defined in that input, then I'm saying increase the counter by 1. Count equal to count plus 1. So if the weekday is going to this much, I'm increasing the counter. So in case the counter has become equal to the nth, right? If count equal to n, then exit the for loop. In case the count is equal to n, exit the for loop. Then you are repeating the process. So finally, there is a day that you are getting here. Now what you can very well do is, here date finder is equal to day. Whatever is the date that got framed, whatever the date that got framed here, that would be your day. In case this entire thing, wherever the counter has become n equal to n, you are exiting that for loop and you are publishing that date as the date corresponding to the nth week of that particular month. Let's try it out. So once I save it, now you will see here, you just type equal to date, you will find a date finder as your formula. Right? Okay, we select the date finder. You can even give an input to the date finder. The nth. Okay, I'll say third. Weekday, Sunday. Month probably August. Third Sunday of August, year is 2012. Okay, something next without for. Because there is NDIF has to be there. Okay, this time let's try it. Yeah, this time it has given a date. Right? So, if you just format this date. If you format this date as a proper date format, it is giving 19th August 2012. Is the actual date. Now probably what you can also do is instead of just finding the date like that, you can put it in our own format also. Right? You can also put it as, so date finder is equal to, probably the format of that, we can very well change it directly here itself, where you can put where we'll put first of all day, right? So where we'll convert the day of that date, right? So day of the date, or we'll put it as MMDDYY format. So the month but it will give me number. So I convert the number into a string. So I'll say C string, convert it into a string. What is that? The month of the D. You convert it into a string. Month of the D is one thing. Then I'll put, so the mm slash is required, right? So that's where I'll say slash. Then I need dd. So I'll say C string. C string is nothing but convert anything into a string, right? And here I am taking the day of the D, which will give me the day. Then again another slash, mmdd, mm slash dd slash, and yy is also required. Again I'll use C string of y, so year of the same D. Now if I convert it, let's see if this works for us for the date finder. Now let me use equal to date finder, my own formula here. 1, 1, 1, 2012, which is first Sunday of Jan 2012. It's not giving me, so it is giving only in this number format, for which I will have to change it into a proper date format, which is giving me the answer. It's giving in the form of a number. 1st Jan 2012 happens to be the first Sunday of January 2012. If I want it, let's say for July. 1st July 2012 happens to be a Sunday. Today is what? Today is 15th, which is the third Sunday. So in this case also, if I change it to, let's say, third Sunday, gives me 15th July 2012. So this formula, I can use it wherever I want. Right? Because there is no direct formula available in Excel. It's better I write my own formula, which I can use for any of these purposes. Getting it? So my formula can be written, which can be used for any of the purposes. And see, sometimes every time, let's say now, why only that much? I'll have for, let's say someone has said for the last 10 years, you tell me when did the friendship day come? For last 10 years, give me the dates of the friendship day. Second Sunday of August. Right? So, okay, I want to find out right from 2001 till 2012. Right? The first, second Sunday of August. So, I'll say date finder, it's not that easy to find. So I am creating one formula. Date finder, second Sunday, August 2001. Right? This is the. We created a formula now. I'll just change the format of this, which will give me, so 12th August, 11th August, 10th August, this is the way the second Sunday of August 2012 has come on. August for I crossed the last. So, I mean, it is not that easy. I mean, if someone has asked you, when is, because most, some of the holidays, especially some of the festivals in US, they are more like this only. They don't go with a date. They go with the second weekend, third weekend kind of stuff. So, to arrive at the date, sometimes it may be necessary for me to have a formula which can pull out this. Or probably someone says, yeah, the second Saturday of every month is a holiday. So, which date it, for each date, what is the date? It's not that easy for me to find that out. So, it's better to go have this kind of a structure, which will give me the date corresponding to a weekday. So, I will think of it and I will create one formula like this. So, this is like my own formula. Like that, so probably I can use some of the Excel formulas itself. Or I may think of creating my own formulas. Wherever Excel formula is not sufficient to address my problem, I'll create my own formulas. Right? Now, let's look at one more. Whatever the data I select, right? Let's say this is my data. If I put my cursor, let's say in this B column, it has to identify the top 10 elements of this list and add them. No direct formula in Excel. Right? Probably if I have to add all, or if I have to add something greater than 100 or 50 or something, I can use some if or something like that. But add top 10. There is no such formula which will directly give me what is the addition of the top 10 or something like that. So, I would like to design one formula for that. Right? So, I will create one more function here. So, I will not say a sub, I will say function. Sum top n. That is what is the function I want. But yeah, what all inputs I will give? I will give the range, in which range I want to do the addition. Correct? I want to give a range in which I want to do the addition. So, selected range as range. That is one input that I have to give. And n. How many, top how many you want to use? Top how many you want to use? Right? And, n as integer. Yeah, probably here I'll introduce something more. Whether it is top or bottom. Right? So, I'll say, top or bottom. When I say 0, probably it will do top. 1, it may do bottom. I'll just give something like that. So, this also I'll give it as integer. Let's try this out. Right? So, these are the three inputs. In a range, I'll say 5 items. Top 5 or bottom 5. You add up. And the output probably should be a double, because there may be decimals also. So, I'll call it as double. So, then I should not call this function as sum top n, because it is taking even a bottom or top both. I'll call it as n sum. Sum of n numbers. Right? So, it could be either top n or bottom n. So, I will take these things as some variables, just like the way we have done above. I will create three variables which will capture these three inputs. Right? So, dim current range as range, dim top bottom TB as integer. Oh, here I did not write it as integer. And dim instead of n number as integer. These three, I am taking those three. So, current range is equal to select range, correct? N equal to num, TB equal to top or bottom, just assigning the earlier one. Now, what is the logic? So, the sum also I have to take care of. So, I'll say dim T sum, the final total sum, as double. Now, initially I'll make T sum equal to 0. Initially, the T sum will be 0. Then I have to check whether the person has asked for 0 or 1 or any non-zero. We'll give it as any non-zero. So, if TB equal to 0, then which means you have to find out top. Right? Find the top n numbers sum. Top n numbers sum. Else, find the bottom n numbers sum. This looks much better. I'll say end if. So now, how do I find the top n numbers sum? Right? I have to find out the top n numbers sum. So, I'll have to find out, okay, I'll create one counter variable, right? So, dim I as integer, something which can loop. So, I'll say for I equal to 1 to, how many times it has to loop depending on how much he has given as n. So, for I equal to 1 to num, next, loop it inside this. Here I have to give num equal to n, not n equal to num, num equal to n, because this is a local variable. Okay, for I equal to 1 to num, first I have to get the ith largest element. So, I'll simply say so, I'll even use one more variable dim cur value, current value, again as double. So, I'll get the current value here. Current value is equal to worksheet function dot large. I'll use a large function of the Excel, where first I'll take it as the range. So, the range is nothing but current range. So, I'll say current range is the range. In that range, pull out the ith largest value. This is the current value. And the sum, so T sum, I'll simply take it as the earlier T sum plus current value. I loop it. For those many times, I loop it. I'll get the value. So, even in case of small also, I mean the bottom n numbers also, I'll do the same. Only instead of large, I'll take the small function. Rest all is the same. So, finally, after everything is over, I'll simply equate n sum equal to t sum. Whatever is the final t sum that comes, that is what should be my answer. Let's try it. So, if I say equal to n sum, at least my formula is coming here, where the input for me here is the selector range. I'll select, let's say, the B column. I want, let's say, 10 elements, 0, top 10. 0 will be the top and 1 will be for a bottom, let's say. End if without a block if. Okay, this per also has to actually have a next. So, if then else, yeah, this per should have a next. Let's see now. Equal to n sum range top 10 top. It did not give properly. Why? Let's try it. So let me try to enter here n sum. This is the range. This is 10. Let's say this is 0. Okay, current range. Current range as the range. So, current range I am selecting to select range. Current range. Current range as range. Here itself it is getting stuck. Current range. See here, I'm not able to take the local variable for range. So, whatever we have given as an input itself, that itself I am taking as the range instead of assigning it to some other variable. So, through that, so here I am not defining something as current range and again taking the value into the current range. That is what is getting affected. So that's where the large, I am trying to find out directly on the selected range itself. So now I'll have the formula. Let's say here on this data, I want to find out, let's say for this guy, the sum of his top 10 performances. So I'll simply say n sum on this entire thing, 10, the top 10 performances, top 10. These are his top 10 performances. If I want bottom 10, n sum, this 10, 0. Oh, sorry, 1. 0 is the top 10, 1 is the bottom. So, probably 10 ducks must be there. So, instead of 10, if I want to find out, let's say 30. The bottom 30, you add up. This is the sum of the bottom 30 scores. The last 30 scores. So, I can find out the sum of the top 10, bottom 10 kind of stuff through my n sum as a formula. So, I can create my own formulas. So, wherever there is no direct feature or a formula available in Excel, and probably to my business, that is very much required. Let's say someone says, no, I always have some data which will do a very complex calculation. Probably A plus B into C minus D plus E into F totally divided by G minus H into I. I do something as a part of my daily activity. I do some kind of thing like this. If that's the case, every time remembering and writing this formula may not be an easy task. Right? Probably to derive my performance score of the company, I do a lot of such calculation. Right? A plus B into C minus D, whatever, whatever. There are 15, 20 elements for which I will have to do something. Now, rather than that, I can very well write one formula once, which will take all these as inputs and do some kind of a calculation and use that as a formula saying performance score. So, the simply I use a performance score, I'll get my output. So, sometimes it's even worth, if you don't remember the formula or something, let's say the world of derivative options, there are a couple of very lengthy formulas. Option pricing formula, there is something by Black-Scholes where there is a very long formula finally to find out what is the price of a call option or a put option. Probably every time remembering that formula and all may not be that easy a task. Rather than that, I write that entire formula once and write a function called Black-Scholes, which will take probably 3-4 inputs, whatever are required. And the moment next time I want to find out the price, I'll simply say equal to Black-Scholes of this much, which will make my job much easier. Right? So, the formula is more effective from that perspective. Anything that we are stuck, anything where we are stuck, anything where a normal Excel cannot give us a result, just like any other VBA code itself, this is also the only difference for this is if I do equal to, I'll get it in the drop down, and using that, I can actually create my own formula. So, just as we see here, equal to something we give, some inputs we give, based on that it will calculate the output and give us the value. So that is majorly the difference between using it as a formula as well as a feature or a sub procedure. Right?